So if you have a sofa that's a standard size, like this size, you probably want something between like 3 and 5 pillows. It's really nice to have an odd number of pillows. So right here I have 5 pillows.
Right.
And also you want to choose, if you, again, if you have a standard sofa, you want pillows that are like 20 by 20, 18 by 18. You don't want to go any bigger than that because they can really overwhelm the couch.
Now, from a guy, speaking for all the men in the world, that seems like a lot of pillows.
Yeah.
On a couch. This is like when I go to my bed at night and I have to take 19 pillows off before I go to bed.
I know.
Why is that the trend? Why is that so popular?
Yeah, you sound like my husband who complains about that.
I know.
I'm not complaining, I'm just inquiring.
These are quite comfortable, and because they're so inexpensive and user-friendly, it really is okay to remove them. You can sit on them, you can chat with friends, move them around. Okay. It's actually not a problem. Yeah, you don't have to.
What happens though? I mean, this happens to be a very neutral gray couch that we already had. You were saying you have a purple couch.
I literally have a deep purple couch, similar to the color of
your dress. You incorporate the new trends when you have something that's already a bright color?
Yeah, that's a great question. So what I would do if you don't have a neutral colored couch, which by the way, if you are in the market for a sofa, I would recommend a neutral sofa so you can swap out throw pillows. But if you have something like a deep purple, I would go with neutrals, something that won't clash with the purple. So like this white would be a perfect thing.
Or the grays or something
And then
like
this
that.
Sheepskin also would be perfect
with that. Looks like a shih tzu turned into a pillow.
No.
That's beautiful. I mean, it's very
so
furry.
Fuzzy
well, this
soft.
Is really in
it.
Right now, the sheepskin. And actually, this is a great example of injecting texture into your pillows. I've got the velvet, the nailhead trim, the linen, the shih tzu, sheepskin.
It's actually a really cool pillow. Talk to me a little bit about the throw, because the throw is really nice.
Yeah, the throw blanket. This is my favorite decorator secret.
Yeah.
So if you get a throw blanket, which by the way, they have fantastic ones at Target, at Overstock.com, at Home Decorators, you can absolutely just throw it on the back of your sofa. But decorators often will take the blanket and lay it down the entire length of the sofa and then all the way down the seat. It injects a fabulous stripe of color.
It.
And also, if your sofa maybe has a stain on it, or it's like a little worse for the wear, it's a great functional way to disguise something.
I want to talk quickly about the accessories, too. These are Nate Berkus. He was here recently,
and
he brought a couple of these, too. I think it looks kind of like a gold sea urchin. I love it, though.
Really?
Absolutely.
The porcupine-inspired accessories.
Yes,
so
cute, and you wouldn't believe how inexpensive these accessories are. So you can actually get these sea urchin accessories at very high-end designer stores. But you're right. These are Nate Berkus from Target. He sells these at Target. Wayfair.com. Has
amazing.
An amazing set of sea urchins. You can just buy a few for a few dollars and place them around your tables, and it looks like high-end design.
Right, yeah.
And really quickly, before we run out of time, tell us about that lamp. Beautiful lamp. And you bring in the blue you were talking about a little bit.
Yes, absolutely. If you're going to do anything else besides throw pillows, get a beautiful big lamp. This is a sculptural ceramic lamp from Home Goods, just a few dollars.
Love that place.
I would highly recommend going to Home Goods for lamps. That's a great place.
Lori, thank
we'll
you so
shopping.
Much.
Thank you.
Thanks
great
for
ideas
having me.
To spruce up for spring.
Yeah.